Another way that corn breeders have improved performance of the crop is through a process known as recurrent selection. That means gradual change in particular traits selected over a period of time. Here is an example from Iowa State University of a tropical material that was selected for adaptation to Iowa conditions. So the starting material was pure tropical adapted corn. Tropical corn is photoperiod sensitive, meaning it doesn't start to flower and tassel until the day length becomes short late in the season. And the plant will continue to grow until it reaches that flowering stage. So this original plant, very tall and very late flowering. What the breeders did was to select within this material the 20% of the plants that were the earliest flowering. And they combined those by cross-pollination to produce this next cycle. The same thing happened here, that the best 20% were selected, recombined, and a cyclical process of gradually moving the mean value of that trait of flowering. So this one, we recorded the dates. There was a gradual reduction of about 3 days in each of these rows. And along with that change in flowering time was the reduced height. So by the time we got here to this cycle, and I believe this is actually cycle 9, this is material that is completely adapted to the central corn belt. And the benefit of doing this is that we brought in this genetic diversity from a tropical material into the U.S. breeding pool. Like many crops, the genetic diversity of corn in the U.S. is considered to be very restricted. So bringing in those tropical genes really provides the basis for continued improvement. So here it is. It's known as BS39, tropical maize adapted to Iowa.